You may have noticed recently that a lot of Tolkien fans, myself included, have been freaking out over the very first promotional image from Amazon's Lord of the Rings on Prime. One of the biggest reasons is the appearance of the two trees of Valinor, seen in the distance of this image. Well, today on Nerd of the Rings, we're going to cover why these trees are so important, and how they directly connect to the white tree of Gondor that we see in The Return of the King. In ancient days, Melkor destroys the two lamps, what were once the source of light for all of Arda, and the world is plunged into darkness. The Valar retreat to the west of the world, where Yavanna sings into existence the two trees, one of silver color, the other gold. We are told Telperion, the silver tree, is male, while Laurelin, the golden tree, is female. The trees are located on Ezelohar, a hill outside the city of Valmar. Watered by the tears of Nienna, the trees glow and bring light to the land of Aman. Each day, so to speak, would last 12 hours, with each tree being alight for 7 hours. Thus, there would be an hour each of dawn and dusk, where soft silver and gold would be given off simultaneously, as one waxes while the other wanes. As with most things, the trees would be ruined by a dark lord. Melkor recruits the monstrous spider Ungoliant to help him destroy the trees. Melkor strikes each tree and Ungoliant goes to the wound, sucking the life and light from Laurelin and Telperion. Discovering the trees destroyed and the world in darkness, once again Yavanna sings and Nienna weeps. Through their efforts, they are able to revive Telperion's last flower and Laurelin's last fruit, which the Valar used to fashion the moon and the sun. While the true light of the two trees would only after live in the Silmarils, which had earlier been crafted by Feanor, there was another great tree that would live on in Valinor. In the elven city of Tirion, upon the hill of Tuna, Yavanna made for the elves a white tree, in the image of Telperion, and possibly from its very fruit. It was named Galathilion, a Sindarin name combining the words for tree and shine silver. While this tree did not give off light of its own, it was still the most beloved tree among the elves of Aman. This tree would have many seedlings in the lands of the elves. So important was Galathilion that it is believed by some to be the tree represented on the doors of Durin, being displayed twice as a mirror image of itself. The other prevailing theory is that these represent the two trees of Laurelin and Telperion. But this is not the only connection these trees have to the later ages of Middle-earth. For Galathilion's seeds would be taken to lands outside Tirion. On the island of Tol Eressëa, a seedling would be planted that would flourish and be named Celeborn, meaning Tree of Silver. Tol Eressëa would be the home to many of the Eldar, most of whom were Teleri. After the ending of the First Age, with Morgoth defeated and cast into the void, and the lands of Beleriand lost to the sea, a new land is raised up from the ocean, a gift of the Valar to the Edain, the men of Middle-earth who fought alongside the elves against the Dark Powers. This was Numenor, the great realm of men who were blessed with long life. Led by their first king, Elros, the brother of Elrond, these men received many gifts of vegetation for their island. We won't go through the entire list of named plants and their various features and functions today, but among them is the white tree of Nimloth, a seedling of Celeborn. It is taken to Numenor and placed in the king's court in the capital of Armenelos. This tree served as a symbol of the friendship of the two races of elves and men. Nimloth would last for thousands of years, blossoming at sunset as its flowers filled the night air with their perfume. However, a darkness would fall upon Numenor. Their later kings turned their back upon the Eldar, and the last of their kings, Ar-Pharazôn, would bring ruin upon the island realm. After taking Sauron captive, Ar-Pharazôn would be seduced by Sauron's words, even making the Dark Lord his chief counselor. Finally, in 3262 of the Second Age, at the recommendation of Sauron, the king has the White Tree of Nimloth cut down. Its wood is used to light the first fire as the unfaithful Numenoreans begin to worship Melkor. But there were those among the Numenoreans who remained faithful to the Eldar and the Valar. Among them is Isildur, who, the night before the destruction of Nimloth, stole a fruit from the tree and secretly plants it so that the line of the white trees would not die out. Isildur accomplishes this mission at great personal risk, during which he suffers many wounds and is nearly killed. But as the first leaf opens of the new seedling, Isildur is healed. Decades later, as Ar-Pharazôn launches his doomed attack upon the Valar, Isildur takes the sapling and sails east with his father, brother, and the rest of the faithful. Numenor, its king, and his followers are destroyed, and the faithful make new homes, Gondor and Arnor. Isildur takes the sapling to the new city of Minas Ithil, where it would live for over 100 years. Over that time, Sauron returns to Mordor, regaining his physical form and his former power. In 3429, he launches a surprise attack on Minas Ithil, capturing the city and burning the first white tree of Gondor. Isildur manages to escape, once again taking with him a sapling. In the coming decades, Isildur would accompany his father Elendil, brother Anarion, the High King of the Noldor Gil-galad, and Elrond Half-Elven in the War of the Last Alliance. As we know, both Elendil and Anarion would die in the war. After Sauron's defeat, Isildur cuts the One Ring from his hand in recompense for his fallen family. Before returning north, Isildur goes to Gondor, this time to Anarion's city of Minas Anor. There, he plants the sapling in memory of his brother. This second white tree of Gondor would last until 1636 of the Third Age, when Sauron's Great Plague reaches Gondor. It not only kills a vast number of Gondorians, including King Telemnar and his children, but also claims the life of the second white tree. 4 years later, King Tarondor plants the third white tree of Gondor. This tree would stand for 147 years, seeing the days of the kings come to an end and the time of the ruling stewards begin. In 2872, Beleg-Thor II, the 21st of the ruling stewards, dies. And upon his death, the third white tree also dies. With no sapling to replace the tree, it remains standing in the court of the fountain of Minas Tirith. There, the withered tree would remain for nearly 150 years until the king returns. After the defeat of Sauron, King Aragorn Elessar is led by Gandalf to Mount Mindoluin, where he makes a startling discovery. Then Aragorn cried, "I have found it! Lo, here is a scion of the eldest of trees! But how comes it here? For it is not itself yet 7 years old." And Gandalf coming looked at it and said, "Verily, this is a sapling of the line of Nimloth the Fair, and that was a seedling of Galathilion, and that a fruit of Telperion of many names, eldest of trees. Who shall say how it comes here in the appointed hour? But this is an ancient hallow, and ere the kings failed or the tree withered in the court, a fruit must have been set here. Here it has lain, hidden on the mountain, even as the race of Elendil lay hidden in the wastes of the north. Yet the line of Nimloth is older far than your line, King Elessar." The third white tree, long deceased, is placed in Rath Dinan, an honor reserved for the kings and stewards of Gondor. The sapling becomes the fourth white tree of Gondor. It would bloom in June of that year, and like Aragorn, restores a royal line once thought to have died out. The White Tree, the very emblem of the realm of Gondor, and in the image of the great Telperion itself, once again graces the great court of Minas Tirith. As always, a huge thank you to my Patreon supporters who make this channel possible. Tom DeBombadil 19, Gail Elizabeth, Jim Limber Davis, Jay Brakefield, Timothy Park, Sky Carcass, Zetrock, Grand Strategy Nerd, The Dark Haired One, Salim Rahman, Wyland, and Debbie. If you enjoyed the artwork in this video, check out the artists in the description and purchase prints of their great work for yourself. Thanks so much for watching and subscribing, and we'll see you next time on Nerd of the Rings.